Hello everyone, and welcome to Crash Bandicoot 2, Cortex Strikes Back. Hopefully I can be heard over this din. We've just spent a very long time setting this up in Discord and voice meter banana. Is that banana?
5 minutes, right? It took about 5 minutes.
Five, ten minutes, probably. Hopefully everything's still working properly and it hasn't just exploded while I wasn't looking, because it likes to do that.
It's hopefully fine.
Yeah.
It's hopefully fine. Oh, yes. Well, now, I've never seen this before. This is the first time we've done this.
Yeah, it's definitely the first time we've done this, and not the second time, because Fraps doesn't like this emulator, and it completely broke it.
Good old emulator.
Good old Fraps.
Now, For those who don't know, I'm not Ben.
Yes. I should have done that properly. We suck at introductions, but we've all been drinking.
You know, I used to be way worse at them, and I still am. I'm Andrew of King Warren Productions.
I'm Ben.
This is Ben of Obsidian Pixels? I always forget whether you put an S on the end.
Obsidian Pixels. I mean, it would be terrible if it was just one singular pixel.
You know what I keep doing is going on YouTube and searching Obsidian Pixels.
And you haven't
for
got
some
me
reason.
Favorited. That sucks.
I have a lot of subscriptions, and you're in O, and it's just a pain to scroll through the list to find them.
Terrible. So, this is Crash Bandicoot 2. This is the nostalgic cornerstone of my childhood. And you've never played this game.
It's a PlayStation 1 game, right?
Jesus, I mean, come on. Anyone in the 90s, you know, worth their salt, has a PlayStation. Had a PlayStation 1, had a PlayStation 1 that ran this terrifying face of Clancy Brown. That's the Kurgan.
What are you trying to say about me? I had an Amstrad GX 4000. It had one game.
It was Accounting Manager Plus.
Burning rubber.
Oh. Ooh, good game. So...
One year later, what just happened? He fell out of the sky.
Yeah. Essentially, this picks up almost instantly after Crash Bandicoot. One, Cortex gets his ass handed to him. He falls out of the sky and discovers the crystals that he can use to destroy the world. And there's Dexter.
You fool!
You're a fool! Sean.
Oh, those are jokes no one will get. Hey, Sean, if you're watching this, we're mocking you in a very cryptic way that only you will understand. I guess. So, I like the way those branches pan back. That's really cool. I gotta say.
Yeah, this game looks alright.
This game.
That is hot girlfriend.
That's his sister. Also, please never call a bandicoot hot again. That leads to places on the internet we shall never go.
Alright, hang on, I'll be back in a minute. I'm gonna Google sexy Crash Bandicoot ladies in my area.
That's gonna be a nightmare. Hey, I'm gonna jump over this mildly. That's not really a pit, that's like an inconvenience. Just do my 12-foot vertical leap.
Yeah, that's like the kind of thing you'd have stop cattle from getting out of a gate, right?
Well, they
have those cattle grids.
Is that what they're for? Do they like take the grid out of it and then suddenly it's like a...
No, they leave the grid in, but the cattle, they ain't going to step on that shit.
Can
their feet go through it?
Is it?
So
it's like cats and tinfoil.
Oh, the cats, can you trap cats with tinfoil?
They don't like walking on it. So if you don't want...
Oh, that's good to know.
Yeah. So, yeah, everyone knows what happens now. I completely walk through here and everything is perfectly fine. What?
Oh, you were teleported.
I was teleported.
The sound effect from Quake.
I love the transporter effect.
Oh, that's my porn star name, Turtle Woods.
That is a terrifying thought because you wear a turtleneck in all your productions. Or is it with a turtleneck?
Well,
I don't want to know.
I don't use a turtleneck. I wear a very revealing V-neck, actually. I used to be quite self-conscious about it because I'd be at work in my scrub top with a big V-neck because I like a baggy top. And I was showing a bit more chest hair than maybe a professional healthcare professional should be.
Oh, we've just skipped over the entire introduction to this. Cool.
The bad guy showed up as a head, and he wants you to collect the crystals for him for a reason.
Good. At least one of us was paying attention. Shall we go play your porn star name?
Yeah, go for it.
Oh, I love warp rooms. You know, games don't do warp rooms anymore. Mm-hmm.
I tell you, I'm working on a thing in Minecraft that you're familiar with, and it has warp rooms. So
oh, yes.
Happy.
Oh, excuse me.
There's like four teleporters in that room.
Oh. Oh, I've really... You know, I think it's because open world video games are more of a thing now, which they're good, but, you know, I miss warp rooms. They were fun, you know?
You should play the World of Warcraft.
No, because if I wanted to... If I wanted to play an MMO, I would just throw money off of a bridge. Because that's basically what I'm going to get out of the experience.
I was in the Deep Run Tram once, which is like an underground tram that goes from Ironforge to somewhere.
Oh, God,
else.
For a second I thought you meant a real tram. I'm like, no. Wow, an underground tram? That sounds really cool. And then it's like,
but
oh,
it's real. It's World of Warcraft. It's real. Azeroth. So I where was it? I think it goes to Stormwind. Ironforge to Stormwind. Anyway, it's not like a load screen or anything. You stand on a platform that whizzes you through the world, but underground. Right? And you can jump off whenever you want, because it's just a tram.
And die horribly.
And you can't. Well, you're down there until you find like a ladder to get out. Anyway, I was headed through once, and I passed some people having cyber sex. Like, they had jumped off the tram halfway, and they were like in the
Obsidian Pixels
tunnel.
After dark.
And that amused me. It really amused me because I only caught about like 5 seconds of it as I came into range of what they were saying and then went out of range again.
I'm glad you
that always stuck with me.
Yeah,
reason.
I imagine it would stick with a lot of people. I imagine it would.
How about what's that country begins with V? It's doing really badly at the moment.
Venezuela? I don't know. There are lots of countries.
I think so. Right. I should know this. I'd know it if I saw it written down. They have people there at the moment.
Don't run the nitro.
Who... Does it go off if you walk into it?
Yep.
I hope you're collecting all of the peaches, by the way, because I'm going to be scoring you later.
The peaches mean nothing. It's the boxes, remember? So yeah, I should probably point out for any purist fans watching this, I am not completing this 100% and getting all of the gems. We are just getting
all
of the crystals.
Don't worry, I'll be making sure.
Oh God. Oh Jesus, don't. Please don't make me. Please, please.
You've got to make sure you collect an even number of peaches by the end of the level.
They're not... Well, that's okay then, because I'm not collecting peaches, so zero is an even number.
Gonna be powers of three.
Fuck!
Anyway, oh, you hit the things! So, RuneScape currency is convertible to real money if you know where to go.
Bitcoins.
And people over there are playing the game to make to farm gold to convert into real money so they can eat.
What?
They're playing RuneScape so that they can get real money so that they can afford food.
That is a terrifying thought. What kind of dystopia are we
and
living
similarly,
in?
Similarly, the currency over there recently dropped below the their currency dropped below the value of World of Warcraft gold. So...
Oh, poop.
Yeah,
ah.
It's not going well for them.
Miss those boxes.
Fingers crossed it'll, you know... Fingers crossed.
Can I slam these guys? No, I forget.
Yeah,
these are...
slam that ostrich.
I'm gonna slam that ostrich real hard, bro.
This is,
I forget. There's
so he's a fox.
Tricks. No. Yes, it's Crash Bandicoot the Fox.
Yeah, he's Miles Prower.
With no tails.
Miles Prower's like Texas cousin.
So yeah, we haven't done any kind of big video productions in a while, have we?
No.
You can tell.
What would we do?
What would we do?
You know,
well, aside from
I said
this...
to Sean once, I had this idea of getting a portable camera thing, which everyone has them now, especially because they're in phones.
Are you about to suggest that we go to? Are you suggesting that we go to the woods and look for a disgruntled witch? Because I can tell you, I've seen that story. It doesn't end well.
I need to find an abandoned house that my friends can die in one by one.
You live in Manchester. Those are like 10 a penny.
Oh yeah. Hey, there was a stabbing near me.
Oh.
I don't want to say exactly where related to me because I realised that it was quite big in the news and people could find out where I live. But very close to my house, there was a stabbing the other day.
Inside. The stabbing was coming from inside the house.
Yes. The chap isn't dead or anything.
Yeah, otherwise I wouldn't have made that joke.
I heard the noise and I was like, oh, those people again making noise. Because
a lot of knife-sounded noises. They're always doing that.
The people in that house are the noisy people, though, so I wish I'd looked and then could have maybe given some information to the police, but at the time, I just thought, oh, it's them making noise again like they always do. But that's not what I was going to say. I was going to say that, don't fall in that hole. Oh, I found the hole.
I fell in the rat hole. Way.
Are you supposed to be in the hole?
Yeah, you're supposed to be in the hole.
Oh, thank God. So I had this idea once that I wanted to get a camera and like just kind of carry it with me, strap it to my chest, whatever, and like do a video, a non-stop video from like from my house, going to the local shops, going around Asda, collecting the ingredients to make a cake, coming back home and making the cake
so
with Sean.
Really, you're basically an early 2000s music video. That's what they do.
And Sean wasn't up for that for some reason.
No. Do you remember like the 90s, the sort of the like the late 90s and early 2000s were filled with really experimental video stuff, like ads and TV. It was just like, it was off the wall. They would do whatever they felt like, and somehow it would be really kind of iconic and popular for a while.
54 or 62.
That's still an even number. Do you remember the PS2 ad? That really, 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 really weird one that was all in black and white, and a guy loses his arm, and he's confronted by three people with animal heads.
I wish I did, but back, like, in the 90s, I didn't really know anything about consoles. I didn't know anyone that had them, and I didn't know what they were, really. So, when you say PlayStation ads, I think of that one. You know the one where they're all in, like, a train station, and everyone has finger guns, and they're all shooting each
That's
other?
That's Xbox. That was a really good
was
one.
That, Xbox?
That was Xbox. Hang on, just to diverge slightly, I really like when that hologram projector flies past. There's a little camera. There's a little lens flare.
Hey, look! There's his sexy girlfriend.
And then the projector disappears. You cannot see it. It's not in the room.
Yeah, it's cloaked.
It's cloaked. It's a stealth camera. It can only fire. It can only record when uncloaked.
I'll tell you about an if we're talking about impressive ones, and I do think this is a PlayStation ad, although you'll probably correct me and say, no, it's Xbox again. The one where there's like a woman giving birth and then the baby flies
No,
out
that's
of
Xbox
her.
Again.
Is it? Really?
It's Xbox. It's Life Too Short.
And it flies through the air and becomes an old man and
yep.
then lands in a grave.
Fun fact.
I mean,
you
know,
want
weird, creepy
not
shit,
only are both those ads that are Xbox ads, but you know the one thing that connects them? They were both banned.
I've seen them both. Yeah, that's probably why I heard of them, because I don't normally watch adverts or TV, but when a particularly weird ad comes out, I usually hear about it.
No, when we're done here, go check out the David Lynch PlayStation 2 ad, because holy crap, it is bizarre as all fudge. Ooh, that's getting loud.
Yeah, all right, we'll do.
Ooh, hang on, I'm just trying to...
Is it like an ad for a perfume? It's all black and white and weird.
Yep.
And Jason
it's all black
Barnes
and white, weird. A man's arm flies off, then it comes out of his mouth.
Oh, yeah, no, that is weird.
And then the duck says, "Welcome to the third place." And then it fades to black and someone screams.
Wait, what?
Yeah.
What did you just say about the third race?
The third place.
Oh, I thought you were making an amazing Stargate reference.
Yeah, I make Stargate references all the time, except when you're here.
Hey, spoilers. Check it out, Pingu.
Spoilers, I have never actually seen a single... Well, no, wait, that's not true. I have seen some Stargate, and I've seen the original movie. But despite my distinct love of science fiction, I have never watched a single episode of Stargate.
We will. I'll make you watch it with me. And we're going to thoroughly enjoy it. It's a great show.
I'm just going to quickly turn this down, because I don't know about you guys, but it's still a little loud for me. Let me just... Yeah, that'll do fine. I'm very
aware.
Seeing
as being professional.
Yeah. Seeing as being professional, we're never going to get that gem, are we? I want to get that gem. I want to get the gem, Obi. I want to get the. Look at that.
If you're being professional, you have to chew really chewy sweet while you're recording.
Oh, yeah. That's like the most professional thing. I'm going to have you killed. Right. Oh, fuck. I can't reach that. Hang on, can I do the crouch jump? There we go.
Nice!
Fucking yeah.
I had the sweet ready as a funny joke, but now I have to actually eat it.
What, you're not like, you don't have like a spit bucket?
No, I'm done.
Ah, you're done. Okay, cool. Sweet. Well, I see, I'm drinking beer here, so hey. I'm drinking some delicious beer, which is aptly. Well, I don't know if it's. Sorry, it's pale ale. It's technically not a beer. But it is called Disco Forklift Truck. I swear to God, that
yeah,
is.
How much they're paying you, corporate shill?
They're paying me way more than you for nameless brand crunchy sweets. There we go.
Actually.
There we go. I've just blown up all the.
Aldi brand fruit chew. Yeah, called fruit.
There's no fucking money in Aldi, mate. None whatsoever. Ah, oh, right.
Not if you're working there.
those
guys.
I kid. Aldi is amazing.
For a long time.
Oh, just avoid the Pingu of death. Right. Okay.
Are they actually what was with the Matrix boxes back there?
Oh, the Matrix boxes. They are not hittable boxes. Right. See. Crash, I should probably dig into the actual game rather than talking about shit, so we can actually, you know, talk about the thing
we're
playing.
Yeah, do that. Why are there seals committing suicide?
They're robot seals. Okay.
Oh, makes
sense. I think all the enemies are actually enemies left over from when Cortex used to rule the world. Or try to rule the world.
Right.
Oh, crap, look at that.
Four. It was that one you couldn't reach.
Yeah, it was a couple of them I couldn't reach. So basically, Crash Bandicoot. Okay, kids. Cast your mind back to any time you've ever had a problem with a game on a PlayStation 2, 3, 4, you know, any kind of point after that. What did you do if there was a problem? You'd just flip open.
I put it down and never played it again.
You see, kids these days, however, what they'd do is they'd open up their Sony Xperia smartphones and use the most reliable search engine, Bing, or Ask Jeeves, and what would happen then is that they would basically be told how to complete the game. You kids were fucking spoiled. When it came to a problem for us, we had to rely on rumour, superstition.
And also the phone lines.
And also, yeah, the game phone lines and magazines. Basically, Crash has a series of hidden warp rooms. Now, you can only access those by clipping through certain parts of the map, jumping through certain pits that you would think you would die if you go through, or just die. It's ridiculous. This game...
Metroid.
Yeah, basically. To some degree. So, yeah. What happens... Oh, God, I've got a timer in the corner. Why is there a timer? What am I doing?
Because you have to get... win... before 18, 17...
No, don't do this to me. Is it this thing?
14.
Is it this
13.
Thing? Oh, God. Because, like, there's this, and these
it's
things
It's just
are...
there to distract you. It's the crystalline entity.
No.
7 seconds.
Oh, God, now some old lady's going to try and kill it. I think that's
quickly
got something to do with
gate.
This.
You've got to go back.
Do. No, nothing happened.
It's your kids, Crash. Something's got to be done about your kids.
That would be a brilliant
Crash have kids? With his girlfriend, sister?
That's not his girlfriend.
Does he have a girlfriend?
Probably not.
Yeah, you know, a guy spends that much time with his sister.
Yeah. But yeah, this game is legendary for having some really brick-hard secrets to find. And a lot of them you would find by accident. And you'd only really find them because someone else would have dicked around in the game or would have read a rumour or heard a rumour that there was a secret here where you'd get
That's
another
true.
Secret to a secret. And it was just, like, insane the kind of... lengths you'd have to go to. See,
oh, that was poor.
That was poor, but because we couldn't work out how to get onto that floating platform, mm-hmm. that wireframe platform, that's why the level is so short.
I wonder if a lot of this is replayability.
Oh, this is definitely...
Nowadays, we have multiplayer things.
DLC.
And, yeah, DLC and games where you have to collect a million weird unlockables and things, which
yeah.
I guess is a lot like this, actually. But back then...
This was replayability because the thing is, you'd think, oh, if I wanted to get that red gem we saw on that snowy level, I'd have to find a secret path in that level, wouldn't you?
Yes.
Wrong.
That would make sense.
Wrong. The secret path is in a completely different level. In fact, it's in the next warp room.
It's in a different game.
Load up some Gran Turismo
you gotta,
2.
You gotta load the level up, and then you gotta take the disc out while the PlayStation is on, and then you've got to put the Driving Simulator 2015 disc in.
Now, isn't there a trick that you'd actually do with PlayStations, that you'd run a game, then you'd open up the console, and you'd swap out the discs for something?
Maybe. I know that you could do that with a lot of other consoles, because it's basically like fudging around with the RAM, loading stuff into the RAM, and then you put a lot of the time it's you put the thing you don't want to play in first.
Yeah.
Let it do some weird shit to the RAM, and then you put the thing you want
I
in.
I think it was to do with chips games.
Retains that RAM shit.
I think it was to do with what is known as chipped games.
Ah.
See, back in the day, you could get essentially a chip to put in your console that would let your console run.
The fuck is going on?
Copy game.
You,
oh, I have
you
some
swallow
limited.
A light bulb.
Nope, I. He's Raven. It's the 90s.
This is pretty great.
This is basically the Crash equivalent of getting a sort of a Mario star. If you get like three of those masks, you get
nice. Hey, you got him.
If you get three of those masks, he upgrades and he gives you limited immortality. But what's nice is the mask is not spent when you are defeated. Sod it. I ain't going back to fight him. There we go.
It's all about them peaches.
It's all about those delicious, delicious peaches. It's actually making me hungry for fruit now. That's something that's never happened.
What? Fruit's delicious.
It is, but...
You ever eaten a mango?
Oh, God, I could go for a mango. I could really go for a mango. It's all this mango beer I've been drinking. I died right before a checkpoint. I'm not drunk, officer. I can steer this bandicoot properly.
Alright, that's great. Do the rest of this let's play in that voice.
Alright. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Obsidian Pixels, this review of Crash Bandicoot 2 Cortex Strike Back. Released in 1996.
It's Penny Crayon. Hello, Penny Crayon.
Hello, very old person who can guess who made that reference.
That was a great impression of Penny Crayon.
Yeah, I've never, because I'm not old like you. Basically, anytime we want to do a let's play with Andrew, we just defrost him. He's kept
me when you need me.
Basically, he's kept in a block of carbonite. You know. I think constantly freezing him is causing bits to break off, but we can reattach his toe with super glue.
Penny Crayon can draw anything she likes. Like cats and dogs and crocodiles and juggernauts and bikes.
Juggernaut? Oh, wow. I'm the juggernaut, bitch. And she robs
usually
a bank.
It's like snakes and doors. Not
so does she draw a door in the back of a bank and then rob the bank?
Things like that, yeah. Like, there'd be a bad guy, and they'd be trapped, and she's like, I'll draw a door, we got away!
So, she's got a magic crayon, then, I take it.
She's got a crayon, and anything she draws becomes real.
Crayons, though, are a shit implement for drawing with.
And also, she's a child.
Oh, fuck, but, you've just basically given, like, near godlike powers to a child.
Yeah, totally. But it always seems to work out.
Can you keep
bouncing on those things forever and get
no,
more?
No, they have about 9, maybe 10 bounces before they break. But when they break, you go right through them, and I'm not gonna futz around with that. But I'm gonna futz around
gambling.
With this. Gambling kids, it pays well. No, it doesn't. I'm a liar. Don't listen to me. No, wait. Listen to me. Don't listen to him.
So I was on eBay the other day,
and
I don't
gambling.
Gamble, because gambling is for suckers.
Gambling's for losers,
but I
kids.
I wanted to get a thing from eBay.
Was it?
And it felt like gambling.
Was it
know?
The Was it the yellow cake uranium that you really wanted?
Yes.
Oh, sweet. Yes.
And I got it as well.
Oh, nice. So
like
a
quarter of the price that you can
get from the black market
elsewhere.
In the middle. Yeah, it's better than those Russian black marketers. Hello, FBI, listening to this recording at our trial. This was entirely a joke and should not be taken as, you know,
also,
actual evidence.
You don't have any jurisdiction here, son.
This is true. Okay, MI6, MI5.
Probably James Bond, I guess.
James Bundy. James Jams Bond. stage.
Jammy Dodgers.
Jammy Dodgers. where were we going with that? Chair, eBay, you were buying something.
Yes, and it felt like gambling because I was sat there with seconds to go, you know, and like figuring out, okay, so I'm gambling on when I should be putting the money down and how much to put down and stuff like that. And in the end, I did get it, which I was very pleased about.
Oh, yeah.
But it really gave me that adrenaline rush in the same way as gambling does, you know?
Yeah.
Oh. Throw me the idol. I'll throw you the whip.
No, it's not Alfred Molina. It's Dr. Octopus. Is that Dr. Octopus, Alfred Molina? No.
What?
I forget who
What's happening? I was talking about Indiana Jones.
Yeah, but the
Oh, yeah, no, it is him. Yeah, you're right.
It is Dr. Octopus. That was his first role.
I wasn't
role.
Following. I was trying to remember that quote about not opening your eyes. Don't open your eyes!
Don't open your eyes! I'm amazing you managed to make Indiana Jones sound like Dumbledore. Dumbledore Jones! It belongs in a museum, Harry. Harry?
Oh, you know what I was going to do and I forgot to get the book. I have the junior copy of Jurassic Park and I was going to give a...
That's a hell of a book to make a junior copy of. Like, are we talking the book? Is there a junior version of the Michael Crichton book? Or a junior
version? I don't know.
Because, like, there is no way.
I suspect it's a junior version of the film.
Because, like, how do you make a junior version of Samuel L. Jackson being mauled by raptors so hard that the only thing that's left is his severed arm?
And a leg.
Oh, yeah, she trips over the leg, doesn't she? Well, that's for a cut scene, isn't it? Is it from a cutscene? Yeah, the leg never made into the actual film.
That's not a cutscene. This is a cutscene. How about some Art Attack? That's an old show.
Oh, that was a great show.
Not quite Penny Crayon old, but...
I'm sorry, no. Art Attack was pretty radical. Do kids still say radical?
Well, you know, I think kids say rad. I say rad. I think the kids,
say
as
sick
well.
As well. They say, oh, bro,
well,
that is not
sick.
Say sick.
I'm not sure they do now.
I don't
fucking
know.
Ill mate. Raz.
Fucking blood mate. Blood is like family member or something? You're talking about family member. He's blood mate.
I don't know. Where I'm from, they say blad.
Blad?
Oh no, you're hemorrhaging.
Oh,
that sucks.
He's blad mate. He's
a really weird
blad
thing.
The impaler.
When I was in school.
So, thank you. That was a terrible pun.
Vigo.
It's Vigo. You're like the buzzing of flies to him. That film is not as bad as everyone says. I died again. Fuck.
No, well, that was the first Ghostbusters. Ghostbusters 2 was the first Ghostbusters film I saw because back then you just watched whatever was on TV.
This is true. This is true. Again, we're both 90s kids. You're like slightly older than me, though. I'd say you're almost... When were you born?
Very slightly older.
I mean, I'm 27 and you are...
I'm less than 3 years older than you. Come on.
That's fair. That's fair. So you're
but
2 years.
That's you're kind of my sister's age. And, you know, we live in slightly different worlds.
Yeah. I mean, but the thing is, we still grew up in that era of, if you wanted to watch a James Bond film, you had to wait until Christmas. Wait, I'm going the wrong way.
Yeah, Christmas, son.
That was when they showed all the... Do you remember that year they showed all the James Bond films for Christmas?
No, but I remember that they often only showed one of the Back to the Future films, and then if you wanted to see the next one, you had to wait a year.
That was a pain in the ass, and they weren't even going to show the right one, were they? They could show you part three.
Yeah, they don't necessarily show them in order either, because what?
It's not even like there's one Back to the Future film you need to skip because it's terrible. It's like they're all pretty good, and they all follow directly on after.
Exactly.
Hey, I mean,
you could probably skip the TV series. You're doing really well here, or at least you were until I jinxed it by saying that.
Oh, you said Back to the Future TV series. That's the word that brings curse. It's like saying Macbeth in a theatre. You just don't do that shit. You don't reference Back to the Future, the TV series.
What a show.
It was a hell of a show. I never saw
it. What was that red thing you ran past? Or was it just like a flower?
Probably.
Oh, it's a mushroom.
There's not mushroom... No mushroom to make enough time for a joke about that. But I went to the Back to the Future ride once. That was fun.
Did you? That was meant to be really good.
It was very good. It even had an appearance of... that was close. Look at that.
Yeah, that wasn't bad. Was that the one where you're like...
Christopher Lloyd was in
like,
it. He's like, Biff's stolen
so
one of the DeLoreans.
You know how I was going to destroy the time machine? I changed my mind. Yeah. Here, have a time machine. Oh, no. Biff took one of the time machines. Chase him down. Do a drive-by.
Yeah,
Yeah,
basically, you have to, like, ram his car.
Run him off the road!
You run him off the time road, and he dies horribly.
You know why? It's because last time the Doc went up against Biff in cars, he wasn't able to run Biff off the road, and this time he just wants to do it.
This is true. I mean, they were in a DeLorean. I mean, here's the thing, though.
And the other guy was in a, what?
Cadillac?
What was that car? No, it was like a Trans Am or something. I don't know. I don't know American cars.
It was big and it was scary.
Do you have any American viewers?
If I do, comment in the section below what car Biff was driving in Back to the Future Part 2, and we will give you a glorious prize.
Part 1.
Is it Part 1? No, it's Part 2.
It was at the Enchantment Under the Sea dance. Well, it was just before that.
Because they chase him in the second film. And he says, Marty's like, Doc, why don't we just ram him, Doc? And he's like, Marty,
don't be a shit, Marty.
We'll die if we do that, Marty.
God,
and he's like,
you're
Doc,
so right. How did
Doc,
I get that wrong?
Doc, I'll be nice. Andrew's a complete another nerd, Doc.
Yes, he is. I'm just going to go back in time and make sure he's never born. That'll solve all our problems.
But while we're waiting for that, let's go fight a boss.
And it did. How far through the game are you now that we've been here for 5 minutes?
We are basically like, that's the first warp room done. Sorry, yeah, it's the first warp room done, so we're going to fight Ripperoo.
Yeah, the weird goofy old man dog.
Yeah, he's a ripper. He's a roo, so he's a kangaroo.
Oh, so he's a serial killer.
He is Jack. Jack the Ripper was actually a kangaroo.
What the fucking idiot? He blew himself up. You didn't even have to do shit.
Yeah, no. That doesn't take his health off. It's the nitro that takes his health down. Anyone else?
Well,
getting...
he blew himself up with that as well.
There we go. Anyone else getting flashbacks to the bit in the Five Doctors where they have to cross that chessboard?
I was actually getting flashbacks, and again.
Is it Stargate?
Actually, no. It's Indiana Jones.
Oh, in the Latin, the Jehovah Jesus. Begins with an R.
Yeah. But I was also thinking about how in Indiana Jones...
In how Latin, Jehovah begins with an I. Is there a book that says Nitro in the corner? I can't read that book in the corner there. This is something.
I certainly can't read anything.
I was gonna do a
reading from Jurassic Park, but I'm sorry I left the book upstairs.
Oh, terrible. There we go. Boss defeated. Now I'm gonna do my dance. Do my dance.
Congratulations. Yeah, that's a dance. Yeah. I can't dance that well.
You know, I'm surprised that never took off in schools.
Oh, well, school dancing was all about running really fast and then going down onto your knees and sliding.
This is very true, and then burning your knees off.
Yeah, over and over again.
We've really not been paying attention to what Clancy... The Kurgan has been saying.
I know that he needs to get more sleep.
He really does. He's been listening to a lot of Bare Naked Ladies. There's always a power that can rip the Earth apart. It's like the Earth does that. Hey.
Is that you?
No.
I'm looking everywhere.
No, you've got my voicemail. No, the guy who tried to kill me like a year ago? I shouldn't trust him? What? Should we get some free lives? Do you want to know a cool secret?
The classic silent protagonist. Yeah. Go on, then.
What?
Okay, you hurt the dog a bunch.
It's a polar bear, but yeah, sure.
It's great.
Sorry, Peter.
What's that international organization that's gonna come after you now?
Okay, honest.
Oh, I see what happened. You killed the polar bear and took his soul.
Yeah, I took his life.
I took his life, and now it is mine.
Should we end the video there, or should we do another rally?
Tell you what.
But Penny's magic drawings are not like any other. They walk and talk and come to life, creating lots of bother.
Okay, tell you what. We're going to end this video here. And we'll catch you. We'll catch you next time. We'll do another one. I think we'll do like a video for each warp room. That'll be cool.
That's a good way to split it up. You should like this video. You should comment. You should subscribe. You should look Obsidian Pixels up on Tumblr and Instagram and Bebo and MySpace.
You've literally named all of the social media apps that I don't use. It's Facebook.
LinkedIn.
Facebook.
And
we use Facebook. We have none of those. Don't listen
to
them.
No one uses Facebook anymore, Ben.
Okay. So, yes. I have
also
been...
Also Facebook and YouTube. Try YouTube.
Try YouTube. Well, if you're watching this on YouTube... Or maybe people are watching this on, like, the broken, like, face monitor of a robot in the apocalypse. In which case, we are from the voices of the long dead in the past.
Yeah. Yeah. But you can download my personality from that thing and upload me into a robot, please.
Yeah, that'd that's some nice. Altered carbon shit. Okay, so, I've been Ben of Obsidian Pixels. This has been Andrew of King Moran Productions. You guys, stay safe, stay beautiful, stay awesome, and we'll catch you next time. Bye for now.
Bye forever.